President, Mrs. Johnston, meine sehr verehrten Damen und Herren, der Präsident der Vereinigten Staaten, der große Sohn.
Mr. President, Mrs. Johnson, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States, the great son of your country, has told me that if I speak German here, people will understand me better than they will understand him. Well, I would not exactly think so, but I should like to give expression to my deep satisfaction, I would even say happiness, to be able to dwell a little in this town, but most of all that I have had the opportunity, and we shall continue to have that later on today, to discuss with your president the common problems which mean the destiny of the world and decide over freedom and peace. We are meeting together in a common spirit, with new minds wide open to all ideas and with common moral values filled with a deep sense of responsibility to not only our own nations, but to all people of goodwill all over the world. We want to fulfill something of the Christmas message, and so between Christmas and the New Year, we want to see to it that there shall be peace on earth. I thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chancellor. The future could bring to us nothing better than peace on earth. And with the fate of the world in the hands of men like yourself and our beloved President Johnson, this will indeed come about. Thank you.
Our guests will now step into the Pioneer Library briefly to visit this historic spot. For the benefit of you who may not be familiar, this is a replica of the original church that was built in Fredericksburg in 1847. Fredericksburg was founded by German colonists, 120 strong. They came in ox carts. They were of all faiths, but they were not able to construct churches for all creeds. They built a building of which this is an exact replica in size, shape, style, and here all creeds worshipped at a common altar. This unity has manifested itself in Fredericksburg, and we are proud that we stand shoulder to shoulder with all faiths today.
Thank you. Our Heavenly Father, we thank thee for these friends from across the waters. We thank thee for these friends and neighbors here at home. We ask thee to bless this food, forgive our sins, save us in thy kingdom, and give us a peaceful world. Amen.
See, I got a sweet, sweet baby who's cool about me. Whenever there's trouble, she's standing by my side. And when the going gets rough, I just roll with the tide. Heidi, come daddy-o, daddy-o. Heidi, Heidi, come daddy-o. River flowing down to the sea. I got a sweet, sweet baby who's a fool about me. Whenever there's trouble, she's standing by my side. And when the going gets rough, I just roll with the tide. Heidi, come daddy-o, daddy-o. Heidi, Heidi, come daddy-o. Heidi, come daddy-o, daddy-o. Heidi, Heidi, come daddy-o. Heidi, Heidi, come daddy-o.
Mr. Chancellor, distinguished guests, and my fellow Americans, last night at the ranch house, I told Dr. Erhard that I was a politician because of tragic circumstances and fiscal necessity had forced me to turn from a politician to an economist. I've spent the last month working on the federal budget. Dr. Erhard, on the other hand, is a most distinguished economist who, for other reasons, has had to become a politician. Others have been writing and talking about the new diplomacy. The Chancellor and I have been practicing it. We've had a wonderful 2 days together. We have formed a firm and lasting friendship personally. Our talks have been full and frank and full of candor, and I think have strengthened the bonds that exist between our two great countries. As I told the citizens of Free Berlin in 1961, and as I have pledged again during the last 2 days, we of the United States have made and intend to keep our promise that for the integrity of the people of Free Berlin, we will pledge our lives, our property, and our sacred honor. Mr. Chancellor, we have experienced a season of great shock here in America and great sorrow. But we stand before the world this morning, one nation, indivisible, under God. We work for peace as the American people have always worked. But like those pioneers who settled this land not many years ago, pioneers who came from Germany, Mr. Chancellor, came in search of peace and freedom, we of this generation trust in the Lord and keep our powder dry. Mr. Chancellor, we shall never be too weary, never be too tired, never be too content, or never too complacent to walk another mile toward peace with honor.